internet is a double-edged sword. On one hand, it has revolutionized our world, allowing man to communicate, gain knowledge, save time, and entertain himself in ways our grandparents could only imagine in their wildest fantasies. On the other hand, it has become a conduit for some of the most primal desires and emotions that we have as humans. Technology has also led many, especially the millennial generation, to become absolutely dependent on it to fulfill these emotions. Of all the desires that the internet fuels, the desire for sex is by far the most lucrative, sought after, and abused desire of all. Pornography is the king of the internet. The porn industry leads in revenue. And when I say leads, I mean with yearly revenues outgrossing global corporations. It leads in marketing by pioneering and setting the pace and literally writing the rules of digital marketing. It also leads in product innovation because any sexual desire that a human being can have, the porn industry can and will fulfill. One of the most unfortunate byproducts of internet pornography is its debilitating effects on men. I spent over 11 years of my young adult life addicted to pornography. Now, while I didn't watch it every day, I'd estimate that I spent over 20 hours a week on it. These days, as an addiction recovery professional, I spend triple that amount of time each week working with men who are hooked on pornography. Some are as young as 16, while others are in their 60s and still unable to get off pornography. So make no assumptions. This is not a small subsection of men. There are literally thousands of men who struggle with quitting porn once it takes over their lives. Now, while they are from different generations, all of them agree on one thing. A habit of consuming pornography online, once developed, is almost impossible to quit. In my coaching practice, I've noticed that the young men aged 16 to 35 who are full-blown porn addicts, and by that I mean anyone who spends more than 12 hours a week on pornography without being able to control it, had no concept of what masculinity was. When probed for an answer, their role as men in society was non-existent. Honestly, at best, their main measure of manhood was how many women they could hook up with or who the most attractive woman was that they could get into bed. They had a rough idea of what masculinity entailed, but pornography and the habits associated with it had essentially erased the basic foundation of manhood for them. More alarmingly, porn was actually changing their brains and bodies for worse. Listen, our fathers never had to deal with high-speed internet and the easy access to pornography. Today, most children are exposed to pornography by the age of 8, and many of them are hooked on it by the time they are 12 years old. So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to break down a few of the ways in which pornography erodes your masculinity. First of all, pornography encourages self-gratification. Delayed gratification is an essential skill to learn if one is to maintain control and direction in their life. Repeatedly giving in to the urge to watch pornography leads to a lack of ability to delay gratification. Your brain becomes more and more focused on the things you find pleasurable, and the discipline of delayed gratification falls to the wayside. It's no coincidence that men who are hooked on porn are usually underachieving in other areas of their lives. The solution to this is learning how to develop delayed gratification. And this is one of the best gifts that you can ever give yourself. There's a certain sense of superiority and confidence that comes with the realization that you have more control over your primal desires than the average man. Mastery of any worthwhile skill or habit leads to increased confidence. The ability to delay gratification is no different. The next is that porn destroys your values. Video is powerful. We live in a world where we need to see something to believe it, and in our fast-paced, information-driven world, video is the preferred means of communication and information dissemination. The thing is, video has the power to influence and even replace behaviors in your mind without you being consciously aware of what you were seeing. See, as you watch video, your subconscious mind is rapidly dissecting, translating, and making sense of what it is that you're being fed. I found that the subconscious mind translates and subsequently changes your behavior in one disturbing way. Pornography programs you to lower your standards sexually. It encourages you to seek sex and, in some cases, build intimate and unhealthy relationships with women or people who are willing to have sex without any boundaries. As exciting as that sounds, having sex with any woman who is available is a sign of a man without much discipline. A man, at some point in his life, must have control over his sexuality. You should not be a slave to your sexual desire. Instead, you should master and control it. In addition to that, hundreds of hours of porn create certain expectations of what sex looks like. I'll keep it simple. Putting your penis in a woman's mouth right after it has exited her anus is not healthy in the real world. The average 16-year-old, though, watching pornography is literally getting his sex education from the videos that he watches. So the solution is, you are what you eat. If you eat processed, sugary food or junk food, you'll feel bad physically and eventually look like crap. So make a decision today to feed your mind only with material which makes you a better man. Here's the barometer for that. If you feel guilt or shame for watching certain material, consider that indigestion for your mind and stop it. The third is erectile dysfunction. Now, virility is important for almost every man I know. The rise in porn-induced erectile dysfunction is something to truly be alarmed about. Frequent porn use leads to frequent masturbation and erections which can increasingly be only induced by hardcore pornography. Porn viewing has become a sort of psychological conditioning which creates performance anxiety. The solution to this is, need I say more? No man wants to kill their boner. You know, if you love your penis and your erections, avoid frequent masturbation and watching porn. One of the simplest and most effective exercises for your penile strength and health are Kegels. There are plenty of resources online that train you on how to perform these exercises. The fourth is social isolation. Pornography and masturbation demand isolation. Anything which you do in secrecy usually leads to shame. One of the first effects of frequent porn use on men, especially young men, is social awkwardness in public, which ironically leads to more shame. Isolation and shame make it very difficult for you as a man to share true intimacy with others, and whether it's with other men as your brothers and friends or with women as partners and lovers. The solution is, many men are already afflicted by shame, which is induced mainly by our society and by religion. If you find that your pornography use has dulled your desire to be social, I know how difficult it can be to jumpstart your social life. Thankfully, the internet can help. Social sites like meetup.com and dating sites are a great way for the former porn hermit to begin meeting people again. The long-term goal would be transitioning to building healthy relationships and bonds with other men. The fifth is goal setting and rewards. Now, in my practice, I have never met a man who was seriously hooked on pornography that was good at setting goals. As I stated earlier, most men who abuse pornography usually struggle in their finances, relationships, and careers, and it's no coincidence. Now, the aforementioned self-gratification is a habit which cannot coexist with achieving worthy goals. Men don't schedule pornography viewing the way they schedule time to work on their business or to complete projects. It's usually, I'm gonna watch porn from now till my body shuts down sexually. Part of this is biological. Now, dopamine is a neurotransmitter, which is a chemical released by nerve cells to transmit signals to other nerve cells. It's a key player in the part of our brain responsible for reward-motivated behavior. Sex, eating tasty food, getting approval, likes on social media, these all trigger the release of dopamine. The more often you watch porn and masturbate, the more often your brain is flooded with dopamine. You slowly become desensitized to its effects and need more stimulation to feel the rush and to get a fix. This means that your reward circuitry is broken. This reward circuitry is crucial in achievements that are truly worth it in a man's life, such as contributing in a meaningful way to society, or developing a highly sought-after or marketable skill, building a family, building a business, competing in sports, or in your career. porn destroys your ability to set, achieve, and enjoy your goals. The simplest solution to this is to become a master of the to-do list and rewarding yourself. Every night before bed, write out a list of everything that you need to accomplish the next day in order of importance. The next day, proceed to knock everything out of the list. Whatever's left goes over to the list for the next day. The key is rewarding yourself for accomplishing tasks on your list. Of course, the reward can't be porn, but it could be something you enjoy doing leisurely. You know, like browsing self-improvement sites or watching entertaining videos on YouTube, whatever it is you do to entertain yourself. Use the activities that usually get in the way of your goals as rewards. The sixth thing is testosterone levels. Testosterone is absolutely essential to your health, to your sexual functioning, and to your general well-being as a man. Here's the important thing to remember. Regular sex stimulates the release of testosterone, while masturbation does not. You feel happier, energized, and content with life after regular sex. On the other hand, masturbation combined with porn torpedoes your testosterone levels, leaving you drained, unmotivated, and filled with the negative emotions of shame and guilt. The solution is, well, it is my belief that if more men truly knew how essential testosterone was to them, they would quit masturbation and pornography for good, honestly. I hope the following benefits that I'm going to mention of testosterone will motivate you. Here's a few things that testosterone does for you. Increased energy levels, increased self-esteem and self-control, strength and physical stamina, healthy metabolism, increasing bone density and strength by aiding in the production of red blood cells in the bone marrow and the formation of blood. Testosterone is also essential to prostate health, liver function, memory, and concentration. So if you've been struggling with a bad pornography habit and you're trying to quit and it's just not working out, it may be time to take an honest look at your relationship with pornography. Now, there are many ways that pornography erodes your masculinity, leaving you weak, confused, and unsure about your direction in life. But it's my mission to educate, guide, and if necessary, help you as a man to repair any damage that porn has inflicted on you.